The testing center is a place of happiness. Students come here in fear, but they always leave smiling. At the testing center, it is our job to give the best quality of service as we administer tests to the students of BYU Idaho. In order to work here, our employees should be able to identify tests and know how to file them away for safekeeping. But some new employees don't know how to identify tests and file them away properly. So you want to work at the testing center, eh? Well, grab hold of your belt loops because you're about to become a testing center employee! When you come into the testing center to apply, you will have to take a few tests to show that you are qualified for the job. In order to pass these tests, you need to be able to recognize the difference in the type of tests we administer. There are four types of papers you will receive: test booklets, bubble sheets, write-ons, and cover sheets. You just received a test booklet and a bubble sheet. This test is easy to organize. Simply set the test booklet aside for filing. Place the bubble sheet into the scanner and press the button. Look at you! You just organized your first test. Not all tests are organized this way. Let's look at some other tests that are organized differently. Do you know what kind of test you just received? That there is a write-on with a cover sheet. The cover sheet is what we will scan in to show that the student took the test. You will staple that to the write-on booklet that has the student's name on it. Staple the papers together. Scan the barcode. And make sure the time has been recorded on the computer. Once you know it has been checked in, sign your employee number at the top, then place it in the scanner tray to be filed. Good job! Let's see how you handle a three-part test. There are three parts to this test: a test booklet, a write-on, and a bubble sheet. Let's look at the differences between a test booklet and a write-on. The test booklet says in big letters, "Do not write" in the top left corner as well as at the bottom. The write-on doesn't have this. What the write-on does have is the student's name at the top, signifying that this test is that student's and belongs to no one else. The write-on should be placed beneath the bubble sheet before the bubble sheet is scanned. There is no need to scan in the write-on itself because the bubble sheet acts as the cover sheet. The test booklet can be placed aside to be filed back on the wall. You know how to organize piles of tests, but you do not know how to organize a single cover sheet. This is a computer cover sheet. These cover sheets don't have any paper with them because the test was given digitally. let's look at the difference between a write-on cover sheet and a computer cover sheet. You can identify a computer cover sheet by looking at the bottom to see if it asks for the computer number. Scan the sheet in, make sure it has been checked in on the computer, sign your employee number at the top, and place it in front of the scanner to be filed away. How are you doing there, champ? We'll leave you to organize these tests in peace. Good luck, and we hope you get the job.